Thank you. I just need to recap in my mind the law of attraction as parents is reflected in the child. The younger the child, the more the law of attraction is mine. As the child progresses in age, say close to 9, about 14, 15, it becomes, as they develop as a soul on their own, they're actually attracted, their own law of attraction comes in.
Yeah, that's true, but when you think about it, even when they're 15, the emotional damage they carry is the emotional damage we placed on them, right?
Yeah.
So therefore, a lot of it is still by having a law of attraction.
Right.
So, like, for instance, sometimes Tristan will phone me, and he'll say, oh, Dad, I'm dealing with this particular emotion. The first question I ask myself is, have I dealt with that emotion? That's the very first, I see it as a law of attraction event that is contacting me.
Yeah.
You follow me? Mm. And the first question I ask myself is, have I dealt with that emotion? And sometimes I haven't. Like, I haven't dealt with the emotion that he's identified for me.
Yes.
And so straight away I try and get into that stuff to help out the situation.
Right.
So the key is that anything that's coming to you is your law of attraction. But anything the child is experiencing is your law of attraction. But as they get older, sometimes what the child is experiencing is based on also the choices that your child has made.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So, and obviously the child's attraction, law of attraction, is based upon their father and mother, not just their mother.
Yes.
So obviously in Tris's case, for example, I've been able to work through a lot of my emotions about women, and I've been able to work through a lot of my soulmate-based emotions, which Tristan has worked through. But there's still some issues with his mum that need to be worked through that I can't help him with, really, because they are issues with his mum.
Yeah, so you're helping Tristan by working through your emotions that are in his law of attraction have become his. But it's harder for Tristan and any other child or adult, for that matter,
yep,
to deal with emotion coming from the parent who actually isn't working with their emotions.
Spot on.
Right. So now I'm getting into us, all of us, the children, and what we have in us is the law of attraction we've actually inherited from our parents.
Spot on.
And if, say for example, my parents were like, they're not,
yep,
if they were actually dealing with their emotions, then it would be easier then for me to deal with mine.
Yes, and that applies even if they're in the spirit world.
Well, that's what my next question. Yeah.
So if your parents are in the spirit world and they chose right now to deal with their emotions, it would make it easier for you to deal with yours.
Right. So I could, in fact, well, they might actually be here, I don't know, but yeah, I could invite them to come to your talks and learn about the divine love part.
Yes.
And that would actually make
your emotional processing work easier.
It's easier.
Yes, it would.
Okay.
Yeah. But what if they decide not to?
Well, then I have to do it on my own.
So you need to ask yourself that question too. Why am I wanting my parents to do it? Do you see what I'm saying? Like, so see, once I hear this information, I'm tempted to say, I would like my parents to do that emotion there. You know, and we start, there is a issue there, mm-hmm, that we may finish up getting down the track of actually justifying us holding on to anger or blame with our parents rather than actually dealing with our emotions still.
So
certainly what you say is true, but don't get seduced now,
yes,
into waiting for your parents to deal with their emotion,
yes,
before you deal with yours.
I see that, but I also see that as a wonderful way of actually helping my parents.
Certainly, you know, yes.
In
the spirit
inviting
world.
Them to,
yep,
to do the divine love path.
Yeah, and many of your parents have come along and listened with you. Many of them, of course, think it's rubbish, and so they don't want to hear any more. And so they've left, you know. But many of you have had parents with you, and you know you have at times, and they've dealt with different emotions in the process. So it's a good thing to do, but don't delay your progression based on their choice. See, the thing that all of us need to come to a point of awareness about is, if I delay my progression waiting for someone else to change. So this is particularly what happens with anger. You know, anger is expecting someone else to do something for you, right? So you're actually expecting someone else to change for you. Now, as soon as you do that, as soon as you're in that space, you have now slowed down your own progression. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
Why do that? Because in some cases, some of the people that have hurt you may be in the spirit world for 1,000 years before they decide they want to deal with their emotion about it. Are you going to wait 1,000 years? Well, obviously you don't want to, do you? So no matter whether your parent wants to or not, still go into your stuff. But what I'm suggesting with you now that you know this information, if you have children, understand this beautiful linkage that occurs between parents and children that you can greatly assist them to deal with their emotions.